Lecture 7, we will discuss the mode and asynchronous counter design and how we can design a truncated sequence for an asynchronous counter, or we can discuss how the decoding logic for any given state in a sequence can be implemented, and also we can discuss the frequency dividing concept of a cascaded counter. So all these topics we can discuss. Now we'll start with the term called modulus of a counter. Okay, modulus of a counter is actually the number of unique state through which the counter will sequence. Means if you are using a 4-bit counter, okay, 4-bit counter, there will be 4 flip-flops, and if it is an up counter, it will count from 000 to 111. So total you will get 0 to 50. So it will start from 0, maximum it will count 50. So total you will get 16 states. Okay. So when you take an N flip-flop in general, the maximum possible number of states, that is a maximum modulus of a counter, is 2 raised to n. So if you take n is equal to 4, in this particular case, you will get 2 raised to n. 2 raised to 4, that is 16. So modulus of the counter is 16. And now we'll discuss what do you mean by truncated sequence. So in a particular counter, the maximum number of states is n. Okay? And where n is less than or equal to 2 raised to n. So if you are designing using a 4-bit counter, but the counter is designed to count from 000 to 1001. So total number of states becomes 10, okay, 0 to 9. So we can call it as a mode 10 count. Or the mode 10 counter is also called a decade counter. Okay? So in this particular example, this counter is called mode 10 counter. In the initial example, the counter is known as mode 16 counter. Mode 10 counter is also known as a decade counter. And in that particular case, then number of state is always less than or equal to 2 raised to n. For n stage counter, the maximum binary count is 2 raised to n minus 1. So you already discussed the maximum count value. For n is equal to 4, the maximum count value is 15. So you can achieve 15 by using this formula, 2 raised to n minus 1. So 2 raised to 4 minus 1. So 16 minus 1, which is equal to 15. Okay. And one more condition, that to get the maximum count from 0 to 2 raised to n minus 1, all the flip-flop must be in reset condition initially. Okay. So then only you'll get, you can achieve the maximum count value by using that particular arrangement. Okay. This is all about the modulus of a counter. Now we'll discuss another property of this counter, that is a frequency division property. Okay. If you use a counter, for example, if you are using a counter like this, and this Q is connected to the next stage, okay, and this is Q0 and this is Q1, and here we are going to apply a clock. Okay. By using this particular clock, okay, we know that there are two stages, okay, and this is the first stage and this is the second stage, and if you apply any clock, for example, the clock frequency of this particular signal is 10 kilohertz. Okay. And the Q0 output. So Q0 output or clock connected to the next stage, it becomes F by 2 raised to 1. Okay. So that is given by the formula. So output waveform is the last stage of any frequency. So this is the first stage. So n should be equal to 1. So f by 2. Okay. And if you take the next stage, okay, next stage output, it becomes f by input frequency, input clock frequency by 2 square. So this is the second stage. So it becomes 10k kilohertz by 2 here. And here it becomes 10 kilohertz by 4. So after each stage, the frequency is divided by 2. So in generalized formula, we can say the n stage, it's f clock divided by 2 raised to n. So where n is indicated a stage. If n is the number of states, if capital N represents the number of states, then n is less than or equal to 2 raised to n. Okay. So now we can see that particular example by using a waveform. And if there is a counter, it's a 3-bit counter. And you can see that it's a down counter, 1111 110 1001 2000. Okay, so this is the applied frequency, clock frequency, which is equal to f, or you can write 1/T. Okay, so f is equal to 1/T. So k is the output of the first stage, and here you can see that the QA output, and if you observe the clock frequency, the duration becomes 2T. So this is T duration, or we can call it as this is T duration. So this is T duration, this is also T. So lower region, this much region is actually 2T. So frequency of the first output, that is FA, becomes F by, okay. If the input frequency is F, you can write it becomes F by 2. So this is a frequency, or you can write f by, sorry, 1/2t, and 1/T is f, so you can write f by 2. Okay. And if you take the next stage, you can see that this is equivalent to 4t duration. So this fb can be written as 1/4t, or you can see that 1/T is equal to f, so it becomes f by 4, or you can write f by 2 square. So if you take the QC output, so third stage flip-flop, so if you observe this duration is, which is equal to 8T. Okay, so you can write the FC becomes F by 8, or by in terms of time, you can write 1/8T. So 1/8, you can write 1/2Q, and T you can write 1/T, you can write F. From this particular issue. So after each stage, the frequency is divided by 2. Okay. And this is another concept. If it is a decade counter, so already we discussed a counter which counts the maximum count value from 0 to 2 raised to n minus 1. Now we are going to discuss a truncated sequence, how we can find the output frequency of a truncated counter. Frequency of an out frequency. So here it's a decade counter, and it's applied by with a clock frequency of 10 megahertz. So we can consider one example. Okay. So the input frequency of a decade counter means the mode of that particular counter. So this is the applied clock frequency, maybe contain more than one stages, and the count value or mode count is 10. Okay. What will be the output frequency or output of this particular counter? So there will be different stages, but for simplicity, I'm just drawing a single block which indicating mode 10. So now the output frequency, simply the input frequency, for example, input frequency is F, and this is a mode 10, so it becomes F by 10. In general, if it is a mode N counter, so output frequency becomes F by N. Okay, that's a general formula. So this is the output frequency equation, input frequency by n. Now in this particular example, the input frequency is 10 megahertz, and it's a decade counter. Decade counter means it's a mode 10 counter. There will be 10 stages. Okay. So mode 10. So output frequency will be 1 megahertz. Now we can discuss the cascade counter concept. So that is, we are cascading two counters. For example, the output of first counter, for example, this is a mode M counter, and output of the mode M counter is connected to the mode N counter. Okay, two separate stages. Okay. So if you combine these two stages, the resultant counter is a mode m n counter. Okay, so for example, if it is a 5 and mod m means it's a mod 5 counter, and second one is a mod 2 counter. So the resultant circuit will operate as a mod 10 count. So 5 into 2. And in this particular stage, the output frequency becomes f by the output frequency f out of the campaign stage. This is the f frequency. It becomes f out is equal to f by m into n, or you can say f by 10. Okay, in this particular example. Now we'll see one example for this. If there is a mode 3, mode 4, and mode 5 counters are cascaded with frequency 12 megahertz, find the number of states and output frequency respectively. So the total number of states of this particular counter. So because the first counter is a mode 3 counter, mode 3 counter is connected to a mode 4 counter, and output of the combined signal is connected to mode 5 counter. Okay, overall response of this particular counter we need to find. So this is the input frequency and this is the output frequency f out. So it's a cascaded stage, so we need to multiply all the mode values. So 5, 4, 3, so the result you will get 60 states. So this becomes a mode 60 counter. So the input frequency is 12 megahertz, so here it is 12 megahertz. So output frequency becomes f by 60. So that is 12 megahertz by 60. So you'll get around 200 kilohertz output frequency. Okay. Now we'll discuss how we can design the truncated sequence by using asynchronous counter. For example, we need to design a mode 3 asynchronous counter. So if you take mode 3, we can analyze. If you use n is equal to 2, you will get 0 to 3. So total 4 stages, 4 states. N is equal to means 2 flip-flops. Okay, and we required mode 3. But if you use n is equal to 2 or 2 flip-flops, if you choose 2 flip-flops, maximum you will get 4 states. But we required only 3 states. So now we got the problem. So we can see that this is a count sequence or state diagram. It should start from 0, 0. Okay, next state should be 0, 1, and next state should be 1, 1, 1, 0. After this 1, 0, again it should go back to 0, 0 state. And if you take 2-bit values, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, so this is a usual sequence of a 2-bit up counter. Okay, so whenever the counter goes to this stage 1, 1, it should go to 0, 0. So there is no state called 1, 1. After this 1, 0, it should go back to 0, 0. So we need to design an extra logic for that. That logic is known as a reset logic. So based on the two values, when it is 1, 1, the counter should again start from 0, 0. So here we need to design a reset logic. Okay, this is a reset logic, and in the reset logic we'll generate a particular signal. Sometimes it will be 1, sometimes it will be 0 based on the counter. Okay, and it will reset this particular counter again. It will start from 0, 0. Okay, and usually this reset logic we'll design in active low state. Okay, in most of the flip-flop the clear signal is active low state. So we'll assume that this clear signal is active low. So we need to design an active low signal when there is a signal called 1, 1. Okay, and we need to clear the count. Now we can see that the truth table of the reset logic. So flip-flop starts from 0, 0, the Y output should be equal to 1. When it is 0, 1, Y output should be 1. When it is 1, 0, Y output should be 1. When there is a state called 1, 1, the output should be equal to 0. That is the reset logic should be 0. Okay, so we need to design this particular circuit. So we can use a K-map here. So two variables, QB and QA, and here it is 0 and 1. So he can see that this particular group, he can indicate it as QB bar, and this group, he can indicate it as QA bar. So you'll get QB bar plus QA bar, which is by using De Morgan's theorem. Simply, it's a NAND gate. Okay, so this is a NAND gate, equivalent to a NAND gate. Okay, now we can see the circuit diagram for this particular mode 3 asynchronous counter. We already got that the recent logic should be connected to NAND gate, QB, QA, the whole bar. Okay, so here you can see a 2-bit up counter, 2-bit up counter by using T flip flop. Okay, so and if T flip flop input is 1 means it's in toggle mode. Okay, and QN plus 1 equal to QN bar. So if the toggle input is T input is equal to 1, it is in the toggle mode. So you can see that TA and TB are connected to 1. And if you consider this particular flip-flop, the other two inputs, you can see that preset and clear. So here you can see the preset input. And preset input means if the preset input is indicated as active low, means if you are applying a logic 0 at this particular point, the output QA and QB output equal to 1. If you are applying 0 input, QA and QB output will be 1. But we don't require that stage. So purposely we will connect this particular input to logic 1. So when it is logic 1, it is an inactive state, because active state is logic 0. So the TA input and TB input is connected to 1, okay, logic 1, and also this preset logic is also connected to 1. So to make this particular pin disabled. And here you can see the clock is connected. It's an active low clock. Okay. Active low clock signals. And we need an up counter. So this is a logic. Negative logic. Negative clock. And Q output. Okay. If you are taking the Q output as a clock. So here you can see the QA is connected to the next stage. So this particular configuration will operate as an up counter. Okay. So we already discussed in the lecture 6, this is the basic configuration of asynchronous up counter. But you can see that during the first clock cycle, the output will be 0, 0, okay, and 0, 0. And during the second clock cycle, it becomes 0, 1, okay. If it goes like this, sorry, it's not 0, 1, and because here you can see that QA and QB, if you consider QA and QB, QB is the MSB and QA is the LSB. Okay, QA is the LSB because clock is connected to the TA input. So QA is the LSB. So initially the output will be 0, 0. So it will be 0, 0. During the next clock cycle, it becomes 0, 1. So this QA output is equal to 1 and QB is equal to 0. Okay, and the next state, QB is equal to 1 and QA is equal to 0. So it becomes 0 and QB is equal to 1. And after this particular point, if you again apply a clock, the output becomes suddenly 1, 1. Okay, when both output QA and QB is equal to 1, 1. Okay, so here you can see that the NAND gate output input is 1, 1. And if both inputs are 1, the output equal to 0. So up to this point, Y is equal to 0 here. If it is 0, 0, NAND gate output is 0. Here also, sorry, not 0, it's 1. It's 1. And when it is 1, 0, it's 1. And when the QA, QB inputs are 1, 1, the output is suddenly changing to 0. Okay. So the output of this particular reset logic is 0, means the clear input of the flip-flop is 0. If the clear input of the flip-flop is 0, means suddenly this 1, 1 will change to 0, 0. Okay. So output is again 0, 0. So after this, so we cannot see this change 1, 1 because this change is sudden. So again, it go back to the state 00. Okay, again it will continue during the next clock cycle, it becomes 01 and 10. Again, when it reaches 11, again it goes to reset stage and clear input is 0, and it will continue like this. Okay, this is a working of mode 3 asynchronous counter. Here you can see the waveform also. So this is a clock signal, and initially the QA QB output is 00, and during the first clock cycle you can see that it's become 01. Okay, and when it is 01, and again in the next clock cycle you can see that it's 10. Okay, and after that if you apply again a clock, there is a stage called 11 suddenly. So during that particular stage, you can see that Y output is suddenly going to 0 because of the reset logic. Okay, so there is a 11 stage, and when that particular 11 stage occurs, suddenly the Y output becomes 0. Okay, Y output is equal to 0. So again, it going activate the clear signal. So when the clear signal is activated, again the flip-flop output becomes 00. Okay, again it continue like this 0 0 0 1 1 0, etc. Okay, so here you can see that 0 1 2, again it's going to 0, etc. Okay, so we can call it as a mode 3 count. Okay, now we can discuss mode 5 asynchronous counter. In mode 5 asynchronous counter, first we need to identify number of states. So mode 5 means we required 5 states. So the counter starts from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So you'll get 5 states. After this 4, again it's go back to the initial state 0, 0. So in binary, if you observe this, this is 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0. So after this, again, if the flip-flop goes to stage 101, it should reset the flip-flop and it go back to state 0000. Okay, so in order to design this particular logic, it's a mode 5. So if you take n is equal to 2, you will get maximum 4 states. So we cannot implement mode 5 by using n is equal to 2, by using 2 flip-flop. If n is equal to 3, you will get a maximum 8 states. We require only 5. So we can choose n is equal to 3. By using 3 flip-flops, we can design a mode 5 counter. So we need to design a logic, a reset logic. Okay. And for that, you can see that if it is 0, 0, 0, output should be equal to 1. Okay, Y output should be equal to 1. And when it is 001, the output should be equal to 1. And when it reaches 5, the output should be equal to 0. And if in any case it goes to state 110, again the output should be equal to 0. Because all these conditions are not included in mode 5 asynchronous up counter. Okay, we require only up to this much. And whenever it goes to any other state, the system should go to the reset logic. So this is the reset logic concept. So by using the KMAP, we require 3 variable QC, QB, QA. So you can see that QC, QB, QA. And if you indicate the values, here it is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So you can see that it's 1, again 1, up to 4 it is 1. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, up to 1. And remaining values are 0. So you can make a group like this. This is QB and QA bar, and you can take the 4 once as a group. So if you take this, this is a QC bar. So, and the final expression will be like this, the reset logic, Y is equal to QC bar plus QB bar plus QA bar. Now we can go to the circuit diagram part. Again, you can see a T flip-flop connected in toggle mode. T is equal to 1, so which is a toggle mode, means Qn plus 1 output will be equal to Qn bar. So it will complement the previous T. So again, it's a negative clock, negative trigger clock, and the Q output is connected to the next stage. So it will act as an up counter. So if you are not using this reset logic, it will operate as, if n is equal to 3, n is equal to 3 means 2 raised to 3, you will get 8 states.
but we required only 5 states. So we need to reset this particular counter when it reaches 101. Okay. And we got already this reset logic, that is y is equal to qc bar plus qb bar and qa bar. Okay, so this is the logic. So now we can see that here the qa bar is connected here. So this is qa bar and this is qb bar and this is qc. Now output of this AND gate is qb bar and QC bar, sorry, QA bar, and this is QC. So output of this particular OR gate is QC bar plus QB bar into QA bar, and you can see that the output of this particular reset logic is connected to the clear input. Okay, so when it reaches any one of these previous states, the output becomes 0, and the counter again go back to the initial state, that is 000. Okay. Now we'll discuss the up down counter. By using a single counter, you can perform up counting and down counting. So this is a simple diagram, and if you observe the normal counter, you can see that it's connected in toggle mode. Okay, so T flip flops. So T is input is equal to 1 in all the cases. So you can see the T A T B T C T D or connected to the logic one state. Okay, now you can see that clock signal is connected to negative edge trigger. Okay, negative or okay, in this particular case is the negative edge, and here you can see that there is a mode control is applied here, that is M, and if M is equal to 0, it will operate as an up counter. If M is equal to 1, it will operate as a down counter. So here you can see that clock signal connected to the next stage is depends on this M. Okay, so for that we are connecting an extra logic in between each stage. So this particular logic actually select either QA QA bar. Okay, QA or QA bar will be selected to the next clock. The same thing. Okay, here it is. Or in general, you can say QB or QB bar. And here also QB or QC or QC bar. Okay, it's all based on this particular mode control. Okay, so we can analyze this particular circuit. So here, if you observe this particular circuit, first we can consider M is equal to 1. If M is equal to 1, what happens means there's a NOT gate is connected, so output of the NOT gate is 0. So if you observe these two AND gates, in this particular case, the AND gate QA is connected to one of the AND gate. The AND gate input is 1, input is 0. Here also 0. Okay. Here also you can say it's 0. And lower side, you can observe that is equal to 1. So mode is M is equal to 1. So the QA bar, QB bar, and QC bar AND gate are connected to 1. So in this particular example, we can see that if one of the input of AND gate is 0, the output is 0 irrespective of the other. So the upper AND gate output equal to 0. But the lower AND gate input is, one of the input is 1. So the output depends on this, the other input. So here it is QA bar. So one input of the OR gate is 0 and another one is QA bar. So here it is QA bar. Here it is QB bar. So here it is QB bar, here it is QC bar, so here it is QC bar. If there is another stage, it will be QD bar. Okay, so Q bar output of the connected to the next stage clock. Okay, so here you can see that this particular circuit, each stage is connected to QA bar output. So it's a negative edge triggered clock. So negative edge triggered clock. And if M is equal to 1, if M is equal to 1, Q bar is connected as a clock signal. So when negative edge and Q bar is connected, this counter will operate as a down counter. So we already know this particular concept, negative edge and Q bar. So next stage will be, this particular configuration will operate as a down counter. Okay, now we'll discuss another case, that is M is equal to zero. If M is equal to zero, you can see that this NOT gate output is equal to one. And here you can see that the lower portion of the AND gate is zero. Okay. So definitely the output of the AND gate is also zero. So one of the input is zero, output is zero. And the other input is one. So the upper AND gate input is one. So here you can see this is a QA. So output of the AND gate is QA here. Here it is QB. Here it is QC. Here it is QD. Okay. So you can see that the output of the OR gate is QA. Here it is QB. And here it is QC. And here it is QD if there is any other stage. So here you can see that there is a negative edge triggered clock. And if M is equal to zero, Q output is connected as a clock. So one is negative, another one is positive. So we know that it will operate as an up counter. Okay. In the previous case, we know that it's a negative and Q bar. So it will operate as a down counter. Now in this particular case, it will operate as an up counter. Okay. So this is a mode control up down counter. Okay. So this is all about the mode controlled counters.